In the Bible, we find one of the most beautiful appeal from God. It says, "Today, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart." Would you like to spend this day with God? Listen to this devotional.
This Day with God, a devotional by Ellen G. White. Cure for covetousness. Continue in the faith grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel which ye have heard. Colossians 1 verse 23. Only the influence of the grace of God will lead men to take their stand on the self-denying liberal side. The cause of God must not in any case be hindered. The message, repent and be converted, must go to all parts of the world. God has freely bestowed upon us His treasures of sunshine and shower to cause vegetation to flourish, and He expects every believer to show willing liberality in advancing the cause of truth. We need now to work as we have never worked before, that the gospel, which is the power of God unto salvation, may be proclaimed throughout the world. And those who are converted to the truth are to be the means through their self-sacrifice of keeping the treasury supplied, that there may be meat in the Lord's house. The Spirit of the Lord cherished is a sure remedy for the disease of covetousness. Talk it, live it. Put on the whole of the gospel armor. We need more of the spirit of prayer and more faith. The first chapter of Colossians holds up before us our high responsibility. Paul says, "As ye also learned of Epaphras, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God." Colossians 1 verses 7 through 10. We must rise to a higher and still higher spirituality. We must cease all complaining and cultivate the giving of thanks. We must work for the salvation of perishing souls. We must lay hold of the supreme power and close our ears to complaint and fault-finding. Crush this inclination and empty the soul temple of evil thinking. Let not one unhappy thought remain within. Souls are perishing in their sins. Work for the glory of God.